Richard Nerurkar. I'm a long distance runner. I competed for the British team at the 1992 Barcelona Olympics, and then 4 years later, the 1996 Atlanta Olympics. First of all, I want to tell you a story that I read recently about one of Africa's greatest ever Olympic runners. In 1957, Abu Bakila was a guard for the Emperor Haile Selassie, and he saw an Ethiopian athlete who came back from the 1956 Melbourne Olympics, and he saw the Olympic uniform that was being worn by this Olympic athlete, and he thought, I want to have that Olympic uniform for myself. Well, the rest of that story is history, because in desiring to get those clothes and that uniform, Abu Bakila went on to represent Ethiopia at two Olympics and make history in becoming the first African athlete to win an Olympic gold medal and the first athlete to defend an Olympic marathon title. Now, I'm telling you that story because the Olympics and the Olympic ideal provide so many inspirations for athletes, both now and over the generations that have gone before us. For me, I was inspired as a schoolboy to pursue my athletic dreams. In 1972, I remember watching my athletic heroes, Dave Bedford and Brendan Foster, take part in the Munich Olympics. And 20 years later, as a 28-year-old, I had the opportunity to represent my country. For me, running has played a very big part in my life and continues to do so. And I think the Olympic ideal of taking part, trying to do your best, and aspiring for the highest goals in sport, and then translating those ideals into your life, have meant a lot to me.